I'm sorry, DCC. Thank you. Maldives. Go. Yes. Oh, oh. No. Hi.
Smart as you.
No, the university guy.
Okay, I need time.
Dear colleagues, I'd like to present the result of our last investigation related to the problem of suppression of column barrier by using the method of coherent correlated states. It is apply, because part of my report is related to the general problem of formation correlated states and to the different mechanism of formation by using different method of non-stationary quality. And maybe the most interesting part last, it's related to the application of the method correlated, coherent correlated states to the analysis of mechanism that take place in well-known successful Lander experiment. I will be discussing three experiments and the authors of two experiments are presented in this hall. Okay. This is a very short introduction that in my report we will be discussing the mechanism of suppression of Coulomb barrier by the optimization of interaction in superposition state of particles. It was shown for the first, not for the first time, maybe next time, that in real nuclear physical system, very sharp growth up to from 10 power 50 up to 10 power 1000 different terrible value and more time of Coulomb barrier penetrability at very low energy, for example, at room energy in the particle correlated states of interacting particle is possible. Firstly, I would like very briefly to repeat some base position of the theory of correlated state. First one, in correlated state. The traditional approach to the physics of charged particle tunneling is based on the assumption of mutual independence of the particle states corresponding to each energy level quantized states. For such system, the tunneling process of each state are also mutually independent. In atomic and nuclear physics, use widely the well-known Heisenberg exotic correlation. This one. Generalized exotic correlation was discovered by Robertson in 1929 for mutual independent dynamic variable A and B. This relation follows from the analysis of the signal-based equation at conditions that the parameter R is purely real. It's a method of calculation from this equation, this generalized equation is in each handbook of quantum mechanics, very simple. Some relation in such view can be used for estimation of barrier transparency using the traditional Gamow exponent. It is very simple if we introduce the mean square effective radial moment of a particle, so we can use such expression, and from this expression follows that in the case of low energy, where the energy mass low, that the average energy of potential barrier, and such condition take place, and the transparency coefficient of the low barrier will be essentially very, very small, well-known result also. In 1930, Schrödinger and Robertson independently generalized the Heisenberg idea of the quantum mechanical uncertainty of different dynamical variable A and B on the basis of more correct analysis of the same expression, same condition. It will remove the underground limitation, this is a parameter alpha inside this integration parameter, a pure real, then we can observe the different ratio. Different generalization of the uncertainty relation. So this relation has name Schrödinger-Heisenberg, Schrödinger-Robertson, or Schrödinger-Robertson, and general uncertainty relation. What is new in this relation? We have the parameters that has name coefficient of correlation. Is the following view. From Schrödinger-Robertson, a declaration follows the simple equation, the simple relation for the case of pulse and coordinate. What's the difference from Heisenberg relation? Different presence of square root from this area. In this case, it is possible to introduce new Planck constant. In this case, we have the similar as the form relation, but it is very interesting. For the case of correlated state, by the way, coefficient change from minus one to up to plus one. So maximal value of coefficient correlation is equal to unit. So in the case of states that are close to the correlated state, we have that Planck constant increasing unlimitedly. It is very important because the Planck constant is well known. It's in fact is a border between classical and quantum mechanical description of the world. And if the Planck constant is increasing, so all world, all universe is quantum object and absolutely different property of such object unit. Let's consider the result of introduction of the correlated states, for example, for analysis of transparency from Coulomb barrier. It is possible to use the same expression. In result, we have the transformation of gamma exponent to absolutely new view. There we have the square root from a unit minus coefficient square coefficient correlation. In the ideal case, the denoted transparency of arbitrary potential barrier will be close to unit at any low energy if the state is close to the totally correlated. But of course, because this square root will be close to zero. The physical reason for the increase of the probability of the Mellick effect is related to the fact that the formation of coherent correlated states lead to the cophasing and coherent summation of all fluctuation of the momentum for different eigen functions. This leads to the very great dispersion of the pulsar and very great fluctuation of kinetic energy. Fluctuation of kinetic energy due to our fluctuation may be unlimited large when the average or middle energy will be low. Very interesting. Very simple schematic description such process. In the case of correlated state, we have the fluctuation of pulsar on different agent state, digit angle, and total pulsar is very small. For the case of correlated state, we have the totally symphysic and correlation fluctuation pulsar on all levels, on all levels, agent levels, and fluctuation of pulsar and also fluctuation of energy may be unlimited large. It is the reason of the increasing of the coefficient of coefficient probability through the potential barrier. It is different description, the same effect. What is the method of formation correlated coherent state of particle? One, the simple method of the formation of coherent correlated state of particle is connected with parametric pumping of non-stationary harmonic oscillator with non-stationary Hamiltonian and such, being firstly in the ground state. There is a solution of such equation, not simple solution, where it is absent, where absent is this normalizing amplitude of oscillator that is a part of such wave function. Let's consider the use of the same function lead to the following formulas for the correlation coefficient. We can calculate the correlated coefficient and compressed coefficient of correlated state. Compressed coefficient is the ratio of the dispersion of pulse and dispersion of coordinate. For the case of states that are very close to the totally correlated, we have the dispersion of pulse, both pulse and coordinate are in limited large. Next figure, for example, it's not important, very important. On these figures you can see the result of the strict calculation of the space density or probability or space distribution wave function under the same potential barrier. This level, it is on a non-correlated state, this coordinate, transversal coordinate at this time. This figure showed the fluctuation of density or probability in time. And maybe most important next result, Harris result. It is an average distribution of the probability density averaged in time for a particle in the same potential well in area under the barrier for correlated and uncorrelated state. On this figure you can see this dotted line, it is a potential barrier, it is a potential hole. For example, parabolic potential hole. Inner line, this inner, it is its density of distribution of the particles that situated ground state in this hole. And the next levels, for example, green, brown, and red, it is a changing of the density of distribution state with different coefficient correlation. You can see that at increasing of coefficient correlation, we have a more deep increasing probability for more deep localization of particle in the area under the potential barrier. This figure shows the same result in the, for different presentation. For example, next this red line, it is a dependence of barrier transparency versus coefficient correlation. For non-correlated state, for example, there was for analysis case when the initial coefficient gap of coefficient into 10 power minus 2, non-correlated state. For the case of correlation is about 0.898 density, the gamma exponent into 10 power minus 2, increasing by 40 order of magnitude. The very sharp growth up to 100 and more times of the barrier transparency and the same growth the rate of nuclear synthesis lead to the increasing of the probability of nuclear reaction and is a direct result of the result of Schrödinger-Robertson modified relation. Okay, the next part of my presentation is related to the method, practical method of formation of such coherent correlated states. First one, it's a formation correlated states at monotonous deformation of potential well. It is similar to this picture. It is two different particles and one particle, and we need optimization of interaction between two particles. It is potential well and potential barrier. Monotonous changing of deformation of potential well, it lead to the changing of specific frequency of oscillation using decreasing function. For example, it may be changing of the distance between two nearest particle with the same magnitude of potential barrier. On this figure you can see the changing of coefficient correlation using such exponential law of deformation of the distance between two nearest nuclei. We have that possible create situation when the process correlation is very fast. From the practical of real experiment, it is not correct, not convenient such method correlation, because unlimited deformation of structure of potential barrier, it is not, it is very far from the condition of real experiment. More interesting is the next situation. Formation of the correlated barrier, correlated state of a particle at limited periodical pumping, with limited to small periodical pumping of deforming potential well. So, in this case, the specific frequency is changing by frequency modulation, but the index modulation is very small. So it is, for example, maybe periodical changing of the size of potential well, or small deformation of the magnitude of potential well, formal small value. This figure shows the dynamic of the formation of correlated states in such regime for different deep of modulation, or deep of modulation, index of modulation. First one, the index modulation, 10%, 20%, 30%. You can see the process of growth of coefficient correlation take place, but of course, more intensive growth take place for increasing of the index modulation. These two two finger, it is a part of this general process. For example, in the area about product of omega zero t equal about 600 hertz oscillation, so maximal value of coefficient correlation here is 0.999, and for the coordinate equal to 1000, its maximal value of coefficient correlation 0.9998. Next one, first big figure was shown to the pumping on the where the modulation frequency equal to base frequency. In case it is different case, it's a modulation frequency, it twice more than base frequency. It's parametric process. In this case, we have more intensive growth of correlation coefficient. Also, the same detail shown on this figure. You can see that very small coordinate is a product of frequency of modulation by that equal about 40. The maximal coefficient correlation there is 0.998, and here in the area about 500, coefficient correlation is 0.9999999. This figure shows the changing of the maximal value of coefficient correlation when frequency of modulation not equal twice to zero parametric condition, but we have some changing from this condition. We have that increasing of difference of frequency, coefficient of correlation will be more small. This figure shows the time dependence of real oscillating and the average coefficient of transparency of average gamma of magnitude for such a system. In this case, we have used parametric pumping. Frequency for pumping, frequency pumping is twice more than frequency base frequency, and index modulation equal to 0.1. It is very important result that will be directly related to the next experiment that we will discuss below. We have investigated dependence, the coefficient of correlation and coefficient of transparency of potential barrier versus frequency of modulation in more interval frequencies from zero up to several hundreds. It's relation frequency of modulation to the base frequency. From the data analysis follows that the process of correlated states formation and the action of limited periodic modulation, this periodic modulation, is possible only at any of two conditions. In the case of resonance pumping, where the frequency of modulation is equal to base frequency, and in the case of parametric resonance, where it's twice more. But in the first case, the peak is very narrow. In second one, the size of peak or area of correlation is equal to the index of modulation. Next part is related to the formation state at full harmonic pumping, such load. Sometimes such an experiment also is possible. There is the same result of analysis of dynamics of formation correlated states. And for the case of high frequency of modulation, where frequency of modulation is close to the base frequency and much more interesting, it is a method of formation correlated states when the frequency of the modulation very small in relation to frequency of base frequency. For example, base frequency of oscillation particles in whole is omega zero, and in the frequency of modulation less by 300 times less. We have, what is the difference? Different only connected with a more long time of formation correlated states. For example, for such coordinate, it is product of base frequency for time is 4000. We have that the coefficient index coefficient correlation is also about very close to unit, is difference in six sign, 0.99999. So, okay. Maybe most interesting part of my presentation, application of the method correlated state to the explanation, to possible explanation of real experiments, the real successful experiments. First experiment. Это трехерцвас эксперимент of Linz, Gravens и Hegelstein. These results were published in different articles. For example, I can use such articles. This experiment was conducted in following way. It was an experiment on stimulated electrolysis in heavy water and also on the surface of a soda made from palladium. Act two red light, red color laser diode, and bit frequency of this diode is controlled, and it's connected, is related to the terahertz diapason. These graphs show an experimental date from these works. It is the dependence of excess power from the frequency of modulation, frequency of action. It is a laser beam frequency. In the interval from several terahertz up to 20-25 approximately terahertz. It is a result of experiment, and in blue it is an approximation that was made by Peter for analysis of such experiment. We have made the more precision analysis of this data. Determinants has shown that such approximation by three peaks is not more correct because there are regions between first and second peaks that are very far from such approximation. We have used more modern method of mathematical approximation, and it follows that in rare cases there are not three but four peaks. Four peaks. But peaks exist this two. There are several fundamental questions in this case. First one, very important question. Why? At coincidence of laser beam frequency, this frequency of optical photon, the energy release sharply increases.
Very.
And what is the mechanism of suppression of the long potential barrier at such laser duration? A very simple question, yes? Next one. Why amplitude of excess power resonance increases of laser beam frequency? Why? Next one. What is the nature of the energy release resonance with a frequency about 20 terahertz? Why there is no optical phenomenon of compound palladium deuterium with such frequency? According to the hypothesis of Peter, such resonance is connected with the resonance of hydrogen in thin golden plate, yes? But very high intensity of such peak and very high excess power, it is hard for me to understand why very high energy is connected with admixture of hydrogen that is a very small quantity is very thin layer. Okay. We have analyzed such laws of distribution of peaks. Depending on the method of approximation, following that there are four peaks, and very interesting, the compression of four resonances lead to very relation. Frequency over 3, this one, is twice more than frequency over 1. It's followed from this. Frequency over 4 is twice more than frequency over 2. Then 20. Very interesting. I would like to once consider the, my preview, presented my view result that related to the dependence of the formation of correlated states versus frequency of modulation. This one, you remember. We have shown from the correct analysis that there are only two peaks of in the peaks of formation of totally correlated states as a function of modulation frequency. It is a distribution of peaks of coefficient relation. Using this value of correlation coefficient, it is possible to calculate the distribution of the coefficient transparency. spectrum distribution, it is not monochromatic line, it is some distribution. It is necessary to average this law by the dispersion of the frequency, and in result we have such distribution of transparency and such distribution of energy release and action of laser, an internal laser, on the one vibration mode. Okay, let's once more analyze such two things. Let's consider the correlation between two results. It is an experimental results, it's theoretical results. You can see that in first case, we have not four independent pair of light. We have two pair shifted by the different frequency related to optical phenomena. These two peaks is related to this pair, these two peaks is related to pair. So, answer to the fundamental question. First question, why this question, what is the answer? It is connected with the formation of coherent correlated state of oscillated particle. What is the reason of suppression Coulomb barrier, very high intensity source? Next question, this question, what is the answer? It is a result of more effective formation of coherent correlated states on the frequency of parametric resonance, twice more, related to the action on the fundamental frequency, this one. Second one, what is the nature of the resonance with frequency of 20? This resonance is connected with the parametric action of optical phonon in palladium deuterium with fundamental frequency emission of 10 terahertz. So, in my opinion, resonance with frequency 20 terahertz is not connected with the real resonance, optical phonon resonance. It only parametric resonance related to the base resonance with frequency 10 terahertz. Next experiment. So, it's a very simple calculation. What is the result maybe in this case? If we have used, investigated the electrolysis with temperature about room temperature, and reaction D plus D, and for the case of non-correlated state, coefficient transparency or probability reaction is about 10 power minus 100. For the case of using such coefficient relation that may be obtained in such experiment, coefficient transparency equal about 80%, equal to 100%. And also for the case of reaction palladium plus the formation of RBN2. In non-correlated state, coefficient of transparency is about 10 power minus 4,000. Fantastic, very small value. For the case of correlated state, coefficient transparency is 10 power minus 8. Absolutely real value of observed experiment. Next experiment is related to Rossi experiment. Unfortunately, I have not the precision detail because it's not top secret or detail. But very interesting, is it possible to application of the massive correlated state to the Rossi experiment? Is it possible reaction? I am not going to describe this reaction, it's not important here. Answer on this question is related to this, connected with the protocol of test of energy catalyzer that related to experiment in Bologna on 6 October 2011. On this figure, this was published. Each can see this result from the internet. What is this? On this figure, it's orange. It is energy input power from internal heat. In green, in blue, this one. It is the external power, outlet power that lead to the heating of water from this system. Very interesting this moment. At the moment, at that time, 281 minutes, it is interesting. Heater was switched off and radio frequency generator switched on. In this moment, the power generated power increased by 2 times. And after this external heater was shut down, but generated was switched on. During the action of radio frequency generation, the process generation is very intensive. So, in my opinion, the action of radio frequency generation is absolutely the same on the Palladio and the system, nickel plus hydrogen, absolutely the same that action of laser beam in the experiment of Little and Peter. Where is such sources of radio frequency wave? Also, it's well known this figure. It is so that entire now heater and radio frequency cable from generator. This. What is the real oscillator on which such radio frequency act? It is not optical phonon body, because the optical phonon body is nickel hydrogen, is about 10 power 30, it's about 10 terahertz. It is not possible using the usual cable for transmission of such frequency. It's well found in the far infrared frequency. But in such compound nickel ash, there is acoustic phonon model. But frequency is what is about from 10 megahertz up to maybe several hundreds megahertz. It's very in good correlation with the frequency, usual radio frequency generator. It's possible transmitting the signal from generator. And also action of such radio frequency to the internal volume of walking chamber lead to the action of electric magnetic field from such source of radio frequency, lead to the deformation of nickel nanoparticles and the modulation of acoustic phonon mode by such law. And this lead, according to our calculation, to the formation of correlated state as separation of prolonged action. This calculation is related to such phenomenon, to such an effect. For temperature from 700 up to 800, maybe 1000 Kelvins, for realization of reaction nickel plus proton, the formation of different isotopes of copper, phonon correlated states, the coefficient transparency is about 10 power minus 1000. For correlated states in such value, coefficient transparency is 1%. It's very large value, and by such transparency, absolutely possible create such energy release and force observing experiment. And last experiment, if I have time. Last experiment is related to the experiment of Mizuno. Mizuno Takahashi is running. It is very, very neat experiment. It was conducted about 5-7 years ago. It's a process of generation of neutron blurs in cooled deuterium gas at variation of magnetic field. You know this. It's very interesting, fantastic result. Neutron blurs were observed at very specific condition, at decrease of temperature. Usually, from the thermodynamical point of view, simulation of thermonuclear reaction need increase of temperature. But this is we have decrease of temperature. The date was the following. At room or some more high temperature, level of neutron activity was about 0.01 count per second. And at decrease to the hydrogen, to the nitrogen temperature, 77 Celsius. And a change in magnetic field from 8 up to 10, or from 10 up to 8 kilorestate, the generation of neutron bursts with duration about 5 seconds, and intensity by 5 count per second was observed. What is the nature? It's a very strange effect. But we have analyzed this effect. I think this is not hard for understanding. In this experiment was used the solenoid with very high inductance, about 10 Henry. And such solenoid has a parasitic surge capacity about 100 picosecond. So, in fact, in this system we have the parasitic surge of solenoid currents. A change of current in external line here, the frequency of oscillation in such system, this frequency is about 100 kilohertz. Reactive resistance of such system is about from 300 up to 200 kilo. Active resistance of such type is much less. At such condition, such relation, the transition from one current regime to other current is connected with excitation of vibration inside this comb. So during changing of current in such system, the process changing of current has a following view. It is an oscillation in such frequency, it is a duration of the duration of suppression of oscillation. Its value is related to the ratio of inductance to the active resistance. And the same law has a frequency, it has a magnetic field. Yes. And next, last maybe conclusion. And in the volume of deuterium gas, neutral gas, there is some quantity of ion of deuterium, atomic deuterium, atomic deuterium, or molecular deuterium. In such magnetic field, the process of Landau quantization takes place. Landau quantization is a process where the motion of particles absolutely similar to the harmonic oscillator. The same wave function, the same step. So, in magnetic field, the process of formation correlated state takes place, and such frequency is modulated by the oscillation of the agent vibration inside the solenoid. Because the absolutely the same law of the changing, the force observed is pre-new case. Of course, in this case, the process of formation correlated states of hydrogen of deuterium ions molecular or ions take place. And it's linked to the very great fluctuation of pulse energy, and it's linked to the simulation of reaction, Giga reaction, between such correlated deuterium and neutral molecular type of deuterium. And answer to the last question, why this effect is not observed at high temperature and has a high intensity at low? It is a very simple question. Let's consider the reference of the solenoid. At low temperature and high temperature, difference about 50 or 20 times. This leads to the changing of duration of such regime of oscillation. Changing of regime of oscillation at low temperature, duration of oscillation is very large, is about, to follow from about 5 seconds. It's equal to the duration of pulse to burst neutron. But for the room temperature or for more heated solenoid under the action of current, the duration of such transition regime is very short. It's lead to very short suppression of the total number of DD reactions. And final conclusion. The performance analysis and the obtaining estimate testify to the real influence of the process of formation of correlated coherent state on the probability and character of the running of the low energy nuclear synthesis. Second, present results claim demonstrate that GR increases by many order of magnitude of localization density under the potential barrier and all the possibility of very effective under the barrier penetration of particle and the increase of correlation coefficient up to 10^1000 and more times. And last, such effect takes place in different non-stationary land experiments with release of energy, including action of laser radiation, ultrasound, thermocycling, the massive supervave, experiment of Rossi, experimental transmutation of Stokes growing microbial system, etc. And last, coherent correlated states cause influence on the penetration probability into the region under the potential barrier, is sustained with the synchronization of the momentum of fluctuation at different levels of the superposition state, and the part kinetic energy fluctuation caused by this synchronization can be realized not only in a parabolic level. Such a state can be formed at least in principle within any system of levels of quantized motion that is not subjected on an external tensor deficit action, provided that a certain coherent action is superposition on it. And also part of this result were published in well-known physical journal like the Journal of Technical Physics. For example, very interesting is what was published in well-known standard physical journal. For example, you can see nothing. Transparency at low energy of non-stationary system. Or next article, for example, interaction at low energy of interacting particle. Or next particle. formation of pervasive and periodical system. So this result were part of the system. Of course, were published in journal reviewed magazine. Thank you for the attention.
Well, I was not able to stop him because his energy level is so high. Well, perhaps we can have a couple of questions. Yes, please.
I start because I've got a microphone. Vladimir, the Deathkalion reactor has a spark gap in it. Now, sparks are very efficient radio frequency generators, broadband radio frequency generators. Do you think that the reason for their spark gap is the generation of RF within their reactor? No. Deathkalion, the group that are our
own colleagues. I don't know. Question to Deathkalion, not for me. I use only open sources for information. I just know.
Okay.
I'm the biggest fan of classical states and coherent states. I'm such a big fan of it that my students are get to work out problem after problem after problem for months. And it's very closely related to you. So the discussion goes like this. You can solve almost anything in parabolic potential wells, also linear wells with these states. It's extremely powerful. So the student inevitably raises their hand and says, well, what happens if there's a higher order term, cubic, quartic? Does it still work? And so I thought, one semester, I thought, yes, it's got to work. Let me put together an example. I put together an example. I got a nice wave packet going back and forth, but as soon as it got into the nonlinear region, it broke up and it looked like a big mess. Well, you know what it was going to look like. So my question to you is, for the systems that you're thinking about, for example, in the case of hydrogen and deuterium, in palladium or nickel, would you imagine that the well might have some nonlinearities? And in addition, would you imagine that there might be some losses, which also make a mess out of the states?
I can present only general constraints, not detail, because I have detailed information about parameter of subsystems, about information, about concentration, about different. I don't answer to your question now. I need additional consideration.
I can give you the potentials relevant to deuterium and palladium. They're in the literature. We have them.
I can use your date about optical phenomenon in palladium deuterium. Of course, there is several resonance, but I have not understand. What is related to the peak with energy about 20 terahertz, because such optical phenomenon resonance is absent. And your suggestion is connected with a proton resonance in the very thin layers. Thickness of layer may be several of strength. The total quantity or total number of atoms of hydrogen in such very layer is very small, but peak of with the energy with the frequency 20 hertz is maximal, has a maximum magnitude. Very strange.
A very minor correction to that.
Peter, maybe the same resonance is two resonances has the same frequency. Maybe it's parametric resonance that applies to.
I'll think about your argument.
It's not additional
investigation. Well, excuse me, I'm going to stop this because in the afternoon the whole panel discussion is scheduled. And I really appreciate three speakers and audience to give our schedule in reasonable time frame. And the afternoon session will resume at 2:00. And I thank you.
Thank you. бери ты свою гадость, Паша. На, у тебя лучше стакан, на.
По $100 тебе с вас брать буду. Чтобы оправдать, да?
Стоп, ё. Стоп, ё, не дикаешься. Пошли есть лучше. Кончайся.
We met before. Very good equipment, yeah.
Now, what's the way they see you on MCI? You put this through?
Say that must be the easiest thing to address fundamentally at an office because you don't have to have a model. You've got to have a prescription,
yeah.
And it's got to reduce to practice. It has to work. As long as those two things are true,
it has to have utility.
Well, yes, I
because
mean,
reducing to practice is not the whole story. It's a bit
right.
More.
Well, if it doesn't have utility, you're defeating yourself to pay any legal fees.
Why did you bother?
Yes. Exactly.
Yes.
It's like my decaf double espresso. I call it the why bother. I get it at Starbucks quite often.
Well, I like that argument.
So I think these are the things that would be really good to engage Undersecretary Kappos in. And again, all my prior interactions with him have been very positive. So I think we can build on that base here. Now, I've intentionally not approached him on his offer to kind of come forward and have these discussions with the patent advisors. I have not gone forward with the cold fusion discussion, although I did discuss it with my director of technology management and industrial relations, who I appointed, Chris Fender. Well, I think Chris thought, well, you know, it's quite okay that as understanding of things come out in advance, that the patent examiners will be open. But, you know, the thing was that the old approach where people, you know, essentially call this an incredible invention, you've got everything exclusive, you know, that was based upon a perception of the past and not the reality. So,
okay.
I think the main thing is to say that the requirement, the reality of the current day is vastly different from the perceptions of the past.
It's a real interesting point. This is almost like the third tier. I mean, it was up until what, the 1900s, you had to actually provide a physical working model.
Right, indeed.
And so now the second one, you know, we've gone through that. You don't have to provide a model, but you got to show that it worked. And then, but now you're seeing the third one, as you say, a stochastic process here. It won't work every time
right.
Until we get further into reducing it to practice. But it
better
does
understanding
work.
Of the material science, better understanding of the process. But
interesting.
That without market exclusion or some likelihood of that, it's
it'll never happen.
But yeah, no, I mean, Bell Labs wouldn't have gone after this owner finding the patent to improve the transistor.
They didn't think there was a need
right.
In a
they
market.
They feel that they had some corporate advantage in doing it.
Oh, yeah.
And so,
yeah.
You know, I mean, another story is that the swap for Sandia Labs leadership for the transistor patent as part of kind of a negotiated deal with Western Electric. Yeah, that got interesting. Western Electric got the patent, the government came in and said, this is just so big, we got a deal. And so Western Electric cut a deal.
So those are essentially those are halfway to marching rights.
Almost. It was like, we have the ability to use marching rights.
We're not going to
use that. Let's negotiate. You know? So they kind of came with a stick at the table for negotiations. And I can assure you, whoever hires something that's just revolutionary, is this going to be my idea?
Same thing might happen.
Same thing will happen. I mean, put another way, do you know of any reciprocity the sovereignty of that nation, if you're talking about a trillion-dollar revolution?
No, they just went off with it.
Nope.
I mean, end of story.
Exactly. So,
yeah. Okay, that's good. Well, we'll proceed.
I think it'll be fun.
But quiet.
Well, yeah. And we'll make sure that
I just figured I'd ask you because you do massive amounts of this stuff. So,
good.
I'm Anyway, so we did the airport thing here. So I did it the other night, and there are 5 hotels on the island, and 4 of them were sold out. So I got a good one.
Столик убрать с вас буду.
Я бы
Ой, ой.